Good morning or good afternoon to all. I'm Olivier Baumgartner from TotalEnergies Lubrifiant. Very pleased to be here with you today to introduce our TotalEnergies Lubrifiant webinars series that are mostly focused on sustainability. Please follow them very carefully. There'll be a lot of interesting information. Thank you and see you soon.
Welcome for a new webinar for TotalEnergies Lubrifiant. Today we will talk about a very nice topic, which is RRBO. But before, I would like to introduce our special guest. Welcome, Jean-Paul Souchez.
Okay, thank you. I'm really delighted to be here.
Yes, thank you so much for your participation. For the audience, can you introduce yourself?
Certainly, yeah. So I'm working for TotalEnergies Lubrifiant. I'm working at the headquarters close to Paris. And actually, I'm responsible for product development, mostly for heavy-duty diesel engine oils. And in that context, of course, of introduction of RRBO, the topic today that we'll discuss. I'm working in this company for over 20 years right now, where I have occupied different positions, like in research and development, as a formulator. And nowadays, it's more like for product development. I'm involved into this introduction of RRBO, and there's a vast program inside our company aiming at introducing RRBO into our products. And this is even, if you can even include it into a wider perspective, which is like being carbon neutral in 2050, which is one of the objectives of TotalEnergies of the group globally. And of course, in the group, we have TotalEnergies Lubrifiant, and TotalEnergies Lubrifiant will take its part in it. And taking its part in it means, of course, taking measures like introducing these RRBOs in our oils.
So Jean-Paul, thank you very much. Now let's go in detail in the topic. Indeed, what exactly is used raw recycling and how does it contribute to the circular economy?
All right. So when you look at lubricants, what is inside a lubricant? Well, you have a base oil and you have different additives. The base oil contributes for like the major part in volume of the lubricant. And when we speak about RRBO, these are re-refined base oils. That is, we will try to reuse this part of the lubricant. So there are different successive paths in that. That is, the oil will be collected. And once it's been collected, of course, you see what the collected oil looks like. It's dark, dirty, it doesn't look nice. And it cannot be used as such. Yeah. So it needs to be purified, it needs to be filtered, it needs to be treated, and then it will be sent to a refinery. Mm-hmm. And in the end, you will find a renewed base stock, which is the RRBO. And then this renewed base stock will be able to be introduced, will be mixed with new additives, and will be like a new lubricant that will be used just like a conventional lubricant.
Okay, very interesting indeed. But as you perfectly mentioned, what also, if we can say, RRBO evolved over the time from hydraulics to light and heavy duty engine and transmission?
At the beginning, RRBOs were used in more, I would say, simple products like hydraulic oils for one very clear reason, is that the quality of RRBOs at the very beginning was kind of not so great. That is, the purification process of the reused oils was not as complicated and as elaborated as it is today. So at the time, we were just selecting what was easier for us and what was not like involving lots of investment. So we started by introducing RRBOs in the beginning in our hydraulic oils. But over time, we have seen the quality of RRBO increasing. Mm-hmm. And because of that, we have been able to select some engine oils and transmission oils as well, where we could introduce them. Of course, this needs to be a full validation process. That is, we need to have a full certification by our products and validation by the OEMs as well. We need to have full approvals by the OEMs. It means passing all the engine tests. So it's lots of investment, but at the end, we have products which are completely, technically completely equivalent to the original products, to the products that do not contain RRBOs.
So excellent. You mentioned getting rid of legislative constraint. Can you explain why this is crucial for TotalEnergies lubricant?
Of course, we need always to follow regulations and legislations. And as we live in the EU, we are, of course, conscious that there is a European waste directive that we need to respect. Each EU member state can go above that and make their own own legislation so that it will be a little bit more stringent. That is the case in France, where has appeared the what we call REP, or REP, Responsabilité Élargie des Producteurs, which is a kind of law that says that we have to pay a tax based on the volume of lubricant we introduce in the market. But this tax is there to finance waste oil recycling. So it's kind of a positive tax, but we can minor this tax if we introduce RRBOs in our products. So it's more like an incentive. So this is true like in Europe, but this also has been implemented elsewhere in the world, like in China, where there is a kind of similar processes. Right. So that is for like this stage, but there is like an upper stage, which is like countries really saying, okay, we need to introduce this amount of RRBO, a certain percentage, in the final lubricants. And so there are countries like Turkey or India, they have implemented these legislations. And otherwise, of course, they're like taxes if you do not put them. So we need, of course, to prepare ourselves so that if such an eventuality would come in Europe, that we would be well prepared. And so we are looking at all RRBO qualities available on the market, selecting the best ones, selecting which ones we can use in each application, and of course, starting to be in contact with all the potential RRBO suppliers everywhere.
Got it. So, in that case, we can say, are you planning to introduce RRBO-based products on the market?
Yes, we absolutely plan to do that. We have already done it in the hydraulic markets, and now is the time for engine oils, certainly, in passenger car engine oils, as well as in heavy-duty engine oils. And so we will put on the market a new range of products that will be called the Ever range. So in case of HD, it'll be the Rubia Ever range, and Ever will be written like EV3R, 3RY, because it's like for reduce, reuse, and recycle. And that's, of course, the goal of RRBOs and of circular economy.
Excellent, and making sense. Got it, Jean-Paul. And you perfectly mentioned the 3R. What concrete impact does RRBO have on the carbon footprint?
It will essentially depend on the quantity of RRBO that can be introduced in a given product. It can vary from a few percent to really a lot. And in what we're interested is to introduce lots of RRBO, of course, in terms of rate in our formulations, sometimes over 50%. And in that case, like for the Rubia Ever range, we have calculated the carbon footprint impact, and we can see that we can go up to 35% improvement compared to a classical engine oil.
So thank you, Jean-Paul. It's impressive to see the results that you can have in terms of impact on the carbon footprint. But now it's time to conclude. How does TotalEnergies lubricant contribution with RRBO align with the company aspirations towards carbon neutrality and more environmentally friendly practices?
Yeah, TotalEnergies aims to reduce, of course, its carbon footprint and by 2050 to become carbon neutral. And of course, TotalEnergies lubricant needs to be part of that and contribute to that. And there are different ways to do it. You will hear also about other contributions, like eco-circular packaging, like immersion cooling in the electric vehicles. But clearly, like introducing refined base stocks, that is working with circular economy, is one of the pillars that will help us reach this target.
So thank you very much, Jean-Paul. Thank you also to the audience for this webinar, and talk to you soon for a new episode for TotalEnergies lubricant. Thank you very much.
Thank you.